Hi, this is Glenda from So Many Colors. This video is going to be my second about using soda ash when you're dyeing with Procion MX type dyes. In the last video, I described the importance of soda ash, and in this one, we'll do a little experiment about when to add the soda ash. You have several choices. You can add the soda ash water to your dye water mix. You can soak the fabric in your dye mix, adding the soda ash water later. Or you can soak your fabric in the soda ash solution and then add the dye mix. We're going to do each one with the same color dye so that we can see what the difference might be between the three methods. I have soaked three short lengths of the bamboo cotton from Wazoodle. Two of them I simply soaked in water. One of them I have soaking in my concentrated soda ash solution. I have put loops around the two short lengths. One on one piece of fabric, two on another piece of fabric. No loops around the fabric that's soaking in the soda ash. That way, once I rinse them out, I'll be able to tell which one was which. I'm going to start by adding about a half cup. Might need to add a little bit more, but about a half cup of dye solution to each of my three containers. And these are just 16-ounce yogurt containers. This is quite a dark blue. I used a couple tablespoons of black and one tablespoon of blue dye. I tend to dye everything very brightly, and I recently started vending at the new Rust Belt Market in Ferndale, Michigan, and realized that all of my scarves were very, very bright, and I need some that are a little more subdued. So these are all going to be scarves that will end up at the Rust Belt. I'm going to rinse the dye solution out. And add about a half cup of the soda ash solution to the middle container. I'm not going to add soda ash to this container right away. I'm going to let the fabric sit in the dye solution for about an hour and then add the soda ash so that we can see the difference between the plain dye solution soaking into the fabric, the soda ash and dye solution, and then the dye solution with fabric soaked in soda ash, and see if there's any difference. So I just have this loosely crumpled. I'm going to place the first piece, and remember this is the one that only has the dye, and I will add the soda ash solution later. This one will go into the mix of dye and soda ash solution. And then I'll rinse off my hands. And this is my concentrated soda ash solution. I'm just going to wring the fabric out a bit, crumple it up, and place it in just the dye solution. I'll press it around so that the dye distributes, but with that wet fabric, I really don't need any more liquid. Again, we'll let these set for a while. After about an hour, I will add a half cup of soda ash solution to this first cup, and after I have them rinsed out and dried, we'll see what difference there is using the different timings to add soda ash solution. The scarves from our soda ash experiment have been rinsed out completely. All of the excess dye has been removed. On the left, we have the scarf that was soaked in a soda ash solution, then scrunched up and added to the dye. You'll see that there is a fair amount of white left. Once soda ash is added to your dye solution, the dye only remains active for a short amount of time. So where the dye attached to the fabric, we have the color, but it didn't have a chance to migrate to the entire scarf before the dye became inactive. Really nice, bright look. In the center, we have the scarf that was added to the mixture of dye solution and soda ash. We still have a nice variation of color, not nearly as much white. We added, if you remember, the scarf damp to the solution so that the dye and the soda ash still had a chance to migrate through the fabric before setting. A nice amount of variegation, but not the white that we see on the left. And finally, we have the scarf that was soaked in the dye solution about an hour before the soda ash was added. Here we see a much more consistent color, and I'm hoping you can notice that we also have migration of the dye so that we have various shades of kind of a blue-green. There are some gray-green areas. I can pick up a little bit of a reddish tone in some places, but the various colors that make up the dye mix have had a chance to separate out and migrate before we added the soda ash to fix the color to the fabric. So we have three fairly different results from the exact same mixture of dye, varying only the time that we added the soda ash. I think it's a fun experiment. I hope you can try it out and see what results you can get. If you use a mixture of dyes that you blend, you will get even more subtle variations of color than the scarf on the right. Have fun with your dyeing and with your soda ash. Thanks for watching.